SBS acknowledges the traditional custodians of country and their connections and continuous care for the skies, lands and waterways across Australia.
You're listening to Australia Explained, an SBS audio podcast helping you navigate life in Australia.
Australia's warm climate offers a plentiful supply of solar energy throughout the year, making solar power an increasingly important contributor to the nation's electricity supply in recent years. In the 2021-22 period, solar and wind energy generation in Australia surpassed household electricity consumption for the first time, as reported by the Australian Bureau of Statistics, ABS. This highlights the growing significance of renewable energy sources in meeting the country's power needs and reflects the broader shift towards sustainable energy practices.
We're currently at about 30% nationally, and that will increase to 82% of electricity coming from renewable energy sources by 2035 under the Commonwealth Government's commitment.
Welcome to a new episode of Australia Explained. I'm your host, Maram Ismail. Today, we will learn how to install solar at your home. Solar energy is experiencing growing demand in Australia and has been identified as a more cost-effective option compared to conventional electricity. Dr. Archie Chapman, an associate professor at the University of Queensland's School of Electrical Engineering and Computer Science, specializes in this area. He says it's cheaper and reduces pressure on the grid too.
The solar energy has a few benefits. It has a benefit to the individual who installs solar on their home because it can save you money. It can provide power to your home load, that's your devices in your home that use electricity, instead of you having to purchase power from the grid. So that's the first reason. But there's two other benefits. One is that the local distribution network, that's the poles and wires that run down the suburban streets in Australia, they suffer from congestion, and having more power produced locally helps to reduce congestion, particularly on really hot days or days when there's big loads.
Solar energy reduces costs and supports a cleaner method of generating electricity. However, Energy Australia reports that coal still accounts for 60% of Australia's energy production. Dr. Chapman again.
Generation in Australia is still largely provided by coal-fired power stations, and anything we can do to offset the use of coal-fired power is a good thing in terms of the effects of carbon emissions on climate change.
Stan Kirpan, CEO of Solar Victoria, notes that after a prolonged reliance on coal, Australia is now transitioning towards solar energy.
We're in the middle of a transformation to renewable energy. The Australian government has committed to 82% of energy coming from renewable energy sources by 2035, so only a matter of 10 or so years from now.
The widespread adoption of rooftop solar panels has surged, making solar energy a key contributor to the country's energy landscape.
Solar on people's roofs, rooftop solar, is now existing in 4 million Australian homes. That's about 30% of freestanding homes.
Mr. Kirpan explains that in most cases, homeowners install solar panels on their roofs, allowing tenants to benefit from the renewable energy generated.
In most cases, the person who owns the home is installing the solar, but there are rebates and incentives, certainly in Victoria and in some other states, that incentivise landlords, so people who own a home but might rent it out to somebody else, to install rooftop solar. And then obviously the electricity that's generated benefits the tenant.
Since the cost of solar panels cannot be recouped quickly, it is generally not recommended that tenants install them.
It's not generally something that is done for the tenant to install at their own expense, the solar, and that's because it's going to take a few years for the power that's generated to pay for the system itself. And so depending on what the arrangements are for the renter, it's not necessarily guaranteed the rent is going to be in that home for that long so that they take the full benefit of the electricity.
It is recommended that you research government websites to learn about available rebates and incentives for installing solar energy at your home. The Commonwealth Government has an energy.gov.au website which helps you find the correct rebate. For example, Solar Victoria offers a rebate of $1,400 for a rooftop solar. They also provide an additional interest-free loan for up to 4 years, and that's regardless of whether the home is owned by you or you are renting the property. Additionally, they provide interest-free loans of $8,800 to purchase a home battery. Mr. Kirpan again.
And in New South Wales and South Australia and other places, Queensland, there are equivalent incentive schemes, but you'll need to do your own research, obviously, in each of those states.
As the world progresses towards decarbonisation, achieving net zero emissions by 2050 has become a central focus for many nations, including Australia. This commitment, aligned with the Paris Agreement, mandates significant reductions in carbon emissions across various economic sectors. Mr. Kirpan explains.
In electricity, there's been significant transformation over the last 10 or 15 years from coal and other sources of energy, including gas for electricity, to renewable energy sources. We're currently at about 30% nationally, and that will increase to 82% of electricity coming from renewable energy sources by 2035 under the Commonwealth Government's commitment.
For information in your state or territory, visit the relevant websites or go to energy.gov.au to find out rebates and schemes available to you. Thank you for listening to this episode of Australia Explained, written and produced by Afnan Malik and I'm Maram Smail. Australia Explained Managing Editor is Rosa Germian. Subscribe or follow the Australia Explained podcast for more valuable information and tips about settling into your new life in Australia. Do you have any questions or topic ideas? Send us an email to australiaexplained@sbs.com.au.
This was an SBS audio podcast. For more Australia Explained stories, visit sbs.com.au/Australia Explained.